Hello and a very good evening to you and a very warm welcome to this first ever live television transmission of the occasion that's become unique in British show business history. That's the Royal Variety Performance, which takes place this evening in the gracious presence of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother. And what a fantastic show we've got for her here this evening. A galaxy of stars. There's Shirley Bassey, there's Max Bygraves, there's Mike Yarwood, Lena Zavaroni, Gilbert Beco, a fantastic dance troupe from America, the Dance Theatre of Harlem. And I see just coming around the corner of Great Marlborough Street now, driving slowly up Argyle Street, is the royal party and the royal car just approaching the steps below me here of the London Palladium. A round of applause goes up from the crowd and the car glides slowly to a halt. And the first to alight from the car, Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth the Queen Mother, was greeted by Lord Delfont, President of the Entertainment Artists Benevolent Fund. Next to alight from the car, Princess Alexandra. She, in turn, is greeted by Mr. Angus Ogilvie. As they mount the steps, the first to be introduced is Mr. Louis Benjamin, who's the managing director of the London Palladium. Next is Reg Swinson, the secretary of the Entertainment Artists Benevolent Fund. And now the Queen meets John Avery, manager of the London Palladium. Also in the royal party are Lady Grimthorpe and Sir Martin Gilliatt. Lord Delfont, president since 1962 of the principal beneficiary of this glittering occasion here this evening, leads Her Majesty up what generations of artists and entertainers have come to call the Marble Hall here at the London Palladium, a stairway to a landing. Princess Alexandra and Mr. Louis Benjamin following closely behind. Mr. Louis Benjamin, as the managing director, of course, gives the services of the Palladium Theatre free on such an occasion as this tonight. At the top of the stairs, Her Majesty is presented with a bouquet by Marion Alwyn, who in fact lives at Brimsworth House near Twickenham, which is the main recipient of the proceeds from this gala evening here tonight. Marion, an old pro herself, she's 76 years old. She was one of the Cochrane girls. She was in many of C.B. Cochrane's reviews. She's toured all over the world, been to South Africa, Canada, and Australia. Still quite active, enjoys entertaining still on the piano, and she has appeared in cabaret. Lord Delfont leading Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, down to the royal box. And as they wend their way down the Palladium corridors, backstage there is a scene of almost frantic activity. That's the Lionel Blair dancers there. Everybody getting everything absolutely right. Technicians and artists make their final checks on the show. This is the Dance Theatre of Harlem, are you ready for their act?
I've just been talking to little Lena Zavaroni, and she said to me, she said, do you ever get nervous? I said, no, never. She said, well, what are you doing in the ladies' cloakroom? See you later.
Well, in fact, we're going to be seeing a great deal more of Max Bygraves later on as the seconds tick away towards 8 o'clock.
Hello, all right?
Yeah,
fine. Ready to go on?
Yeah,
just about. What about you?
Well, there are two of the newer artists on the show tonight, Wayne King and Dawson Chance, exchanging good wishes to each other. Nervous greetings, a lot of tension back there tonight. And it's also a mammoth technical operation too. That's slipping into full gear. Final checks are made to the delicate electronic gear that's necessary to bring this glamorous and very exciting night to you live on BBC One at home.
The royal party have arrived.
Oh, thank you very much. How long have I got?
Oh, you've got a few minutes yet.
Homer, what time are we going to start?
We have less than 10 minutes. We better hurry.
Hello, Eddie.
Can you keep still?
I'm trying to make me pretty.
Yes, stand by, yes.
Well, there we are, Nookie. Didn't she look nice?
Yeah, she did indeed, yeah.
Lovely bouquet of flowers.
I'll go over there.
Did you? Where'd you get the flowers from?
Oh, nicked them.
Did you?
Yeah. I've got to get ready now.
Have you?
Gonna polish my nose.
Well, they say that waiting in the wings is the worst part of show business, and it must be more so tonight. There's nearly 3,000 people inside the London Palladium here. There's the presence of royalty just taking their places in the royal box, and a television audience, of course, around the world that must amount to hundreds and hundreds of millions, all live from the London Palladium. To be an astonishing night in the theatre. Max Bygraves, of course, making his unique 14th appearance on a Royal Variety performance. No man, no woman has ever appeared so many times on the Royal Variety show. Max, of course, doing very well at the moment with his BBC Two series. He'll be introducing Shirley Bassey, as I said before, who has got her own spectacular series of shows running on BBC One on Saturday night. There's a brilliant young Australian concert pianist we'll be seeing. His name is Wayne King. And a chap who's often billed as one of Britain's brightest hopes on the comedy scene, I suppose he's got to be if he comes from Bootle, his name is Tom O'Connor. Altogether, an interesting and exciting evening ahead of us here in this theatre, the London Palladium, which was opened on Boxing Night 1926, and it's seen many an exciting evening between now and since then. In fact, this particular little corner of London is no stranger to royalty. Argyle Street, in which the London Palladium stands, is the site of the homes of the former Dukes of Argyle. They built mansions here going back to as far as 1750. In fact, Lord Aberdeen, one-time Prime Minister and diplomat and statesman, he lived in a house on this site until around about 1860. And when variety was in its heyday and many performers played two and three different theatres a night, there were probably more than 60 music halls of this type in and around London. But this, the London Palladium, the only one left, opened, as I say, Boxing Day 1910. And with the centre of gravity of London moving west in the 19th century, it was inevitable that this house and its enormous garden owned by the Dukes of Argyle would attract the beady eyes of the property developers. But its possibilities were not really exploited until 1871, when one of the most famous names in the circus world, that was a chap called Frederick Charles Hengler. He offered a rent of about £1,000 for a 10-year lease to build a ring, a circus ring, on this site. Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, is in the box.
Evening all. Now every show has got to have an opening. It's got to have good taste, finesse and flair. And an opening always brings a lot of problems. At least it did to our director who's back there. Now the problem that confronts every producer is they spend a fortune on an opening plot. And then as sure as fate, a party comes in late. If you don't believe me, have a look at this lot. Can I help you?
Trying to find our seats.
Let's have a look. I know where all the seats are. Show them to me. Pass them up here, could you? Hurry up. You're a bit late, you know. You yeah. In business?
Yes.
You wouldn't like it if I was late for you, would you?
Wouldn't worry me, mate. I'm an undertaker.
Well, shouldn't you have a box? These tickets are not for here. This is for the Jimmy Tarbuck show. The Victoria Palace.
Ah, who are you then?
I'm the soap powder man.
What, Almo?
No, I'm quite normal. Here you are, it's a... Victoria, if you hurry up, you'll just get the curtain going up, yeah.
Thanks, mate. Okay, carry on.
Go on, tell her. So I said, I think I've got a good idea. This is true, I'm telling you the facts. I said, I got an idea for an opening. So sit back, enjoy it, and relax. I said, why don't we start with the finale? Why not begin with the last scene? Let's have the ending right here and now. Then they can play God Save the Queen. Let's see the showgirls in sequins. Let's hear the orchestra blow. And if you don't like the finale, well, you don't have to stay for the show. Ladies and gentlemen, the Lionel Blair dancers. Entertain you tonight. Los Reales, Dawson Chance, Roger DeCourcy, Wayne King, Tom O'Connor, Lena Zavaroni, the Dance Theater of Harlem, Mike Yarwood, Gilbert Gilberto, and Shirley Bassey. See the showgirls in sequin. Let's hear the orchestra blow. And if you don't like our finale, well, you don't have to stay. Take it away. Don't have to stay for the show. You've been a great audience, ladies and gentlemen. Have a safe journey home. That's not much for £50, is it? £50 for a seat you've paid. I wouldn't pay that to see me. And I'm worth it. I've been watching that on television. I've never seen anything like it. The store's coming in now. I've never seen so many diamonds and rubies and minks and Rolls Royces. Do you know, if there was a robbery tonight, Shaw Taylor would have a job for life. I hope those fellas from the International Monetary Fund aren't looking in. Otherwise, they'd be coming to us for a loan. Now, I'll tell you what I'm doing here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the compere, you see. On a night like this, they said, well, what they'd like is a nice, clean, living sort of image. That was before I did the Michael Parkinson show, wasn't it? And upset all the Sophie Tucker fans. But you see, what they did, they got all the well-known stars, all the well-known compares in showbiz, people like Bruce Forsyth and Bob Monkhouse and Huey Green, and we drew lots for this job, and I lost. But my loss is your gain, because originally we were going to have Bernard Manning. But he couldn't do it tonight because he's giving charm lessons to Enoch Powell. Now, this show is live, you know, it's going out live at this moment. You must have heard that. And in case, I'm telling you, this is me, in case you think it's Mike Yarwood doing an impression, you know. And so if people come on here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and especially those viewing at home, if they come on and they fluff their lines and they forget it, they have a blackout, be tolerant. Pretend you're watching Crossroads. Now, all the people at home, they'll watch the show until about 9:15, and then at 9:15, Angela Rippon will do a sit-down stand-up act. I think she can stand up. Rumour has it she's on casters. And if you go out to make a cup of tea, don't worry, because at the end of the evening, Jimmy Hill is going to do an instant replay and tell us where we all went wrong. So we're going to start with a song that is called Back in My Childhood Days, and it goes something like this. Things that we did when I was a kid, they keep coming back to me. The games that we played and the friends that we made keep haunting my memory. I get so nostalgic remembering when the Biff Bat and the Yo-Yo were the craze. Garbo and Myrna, Lloyd Jolson and Sonny Boy, they were my childhood days. King George wore a monocle, we read the News Chronicle.
Back in my childhood days.
There was Gandhi and Lenin, Lady Astor and Bevin.
Back in my childhood days.
We all used to cram on a 68 tram. The railways didn't have those long delays.
The gentry played polo, Amy Johnson flew solo. Back in my childhood days.
There was Elsie and Doris, Marlena and Morris,
back in my childhood days.
There was Chesney and Bardan, the great lobby lad,
back in my childhood days.
We were fishing with worms, all the women had perms. They didn't wear a bra, they called them stays. There was Popeye the Sailor and the 50 Bob Taylor,
back in my childhood days.
To sing songs recorded by Bing,
back in my childhood days.
There were carousel rides, we had short back and sides,
back in my childhood days.
I once saw a zeppelin up in the sky, I saw the Crystal Palace all ablaze.
We joined the Boy Scouts, all we grew up as louts, back in my childhood days.
We used to ride scooters, we all had pea shooters, back in my childhood days.
We used to go hiking, we used to go biking, back in my childhood days.
We were hopping the wag, we were having a drag,
the rumba and the tango were craze.
We lived in the flats, we had kiss me quick hats,
back in my childhood days.
Fourpence a pint cost the same,
back in my childhood days.
A rhubarb and custard, a corned beef and mustard,
back in my childhood days.
Licorice and lollipop, sherbet and acid drops, and salad but without the mayonnaise. And to go through your hair, Nitty Nora was there,
back in my childhood.
Sick, we were rubbed in with Vic, back in my childhood days. Sandbach and Germaline, Classic and Thermogene,
back in my childhood days.
Friday was bath night with syrup of figs, we spit it out all over the place. And the doctor would come if you'd a rash on your bum,
back in my childhood
day. A great act, ladies and gentlemen, now from Paraguay, the Los Reales. Give them a hand, the Los Reales.
Muchísimas gracias.
Sí.
Señoras y señores, muy buenas noches. Thank you very mucho.
Oh, thank you very much and good evening. That's what he said. Greetings to all of you from South America, our continent. Very special from Paraguay with this song in the Paraguayan harp. Well, now everybody have to clap hands. Come on.
Come on, everybody.
This is a happy song, which is going to take you to the sunshine. And this is the way we go, garden. One, 2, 3, 4. Entre flores, fandanguillos y alegría, nació España, la tierra del amor. Solo Dios ser tanta belleza,
es imposible que pueda dar dos, y todo el mundo sabe que es verdad, y lloran cuando tienen que marchar, por eso se oye este refrán, que viva la España, y siempre la recordarán.
Paseando esa cuadrilla
con esa gracia de hidalgo español, la plaza con su sol que empieza nuestra fiesta nacional.
La gente canta con la...
saucy with nothing.
Lovely. There we go. Right, let's see if he's in. Come on, young man. Dalton, come on. Good evening.
What are you doing?
Oh, watching her organ on.
Pardon?
It's live this year, isn't it? The sun geezer talking to a dox. Hold it, I just recognised who it is. Oh dear.
Come on!
Well, we are on the Royal Command. Are we? Good, innit? Is she here?
Yes, she's here.
Where is she?
She's in a box.
Well, it's better than nine. You're...
Come on out. Okay, come. Just sit down.
Thank you.
It's a Nookie?
Yeah, that's 9-8.
Your name's Nookie?
Yeah.
I said, your Christian name?
Do I look Jewish?
No. Yeah. Go on. Nookie, where do you come from?
A royal zoo.
Do you?
Yeah.
Chisington. Chisington. I said, do you live in a cage?
Well, I ain't got a semi-detached house, have I? No, right now. Where would I get a mortgage?
All right.
Yeah. Come out here, you asking a stupid question.
Come here!
Hey?
I'm coming from Chessington, young man, you were...
Young man.
Finished?
Yeah.
Coming from Chessington, young man.
Better.
Thank you. You're what you call an intellectual bear.
Hey?
Intellectual, IQ.
I'll go in and nick it.
No. IQ is a level of your intelligence.
Is it? Good, isn't it?
What is your IQ?
308.
Don't be stupid.
You started it.
Right, yeah. Come on, what is your IQ?
I've got an IQ. Or the 11.
11?
Yeah.
That's not very many.
It's good for a dare.
Is it?
Yeah.
Still not very many.
Took two goes to get that.
All right, yeah. With this tremendous IQ of 11, what have you been doing recently?
Me?
You?
Yeah. I've just done a new series of Mastermind.
Mastermind?
Yeah.
I see. And with this new series of Mastermind, who asked you the questions?
I forgot it.
Yes. It's Magnusson.
Student name.
Listen, he's a very intelligent man.
He's
intelligent. He ought to do. He's got all the answers written down. All right, yeah. What did you answer questions on?
Greek mythology. East End.
Pardon?
East End Greek mythology. On an extra.
There isn't a lot to know.
That's why on an extra.
Yeah. Right.
Ask me a question.
Ask you a question?
Yeah.
Right, okay. We'll do it like Mastermind.
Okay. This time. What do you think I'm up there, a North?
All right. Come on. This is how he does it on Mastermind. He's kinky. Yes, all right. Have the honeymoon in the lighthouse? We don't want to know. No, come on. Concentrate. Okay. Good evening.
Good evening.
Mastermind.
Master Nine.
Greek mythology.
East End.
What's your name?
Pass.
Pass. What do you mean, pass?
We've got nothing to do in Greek mythology, is it?
Trick question, you lose a point.
End up with a night out with Eddie Waring.
Yes, all right.
Each an up and under. He's a good runner.
Come on, yeah. Let's ask you some questions.
Okay.
Talk about animals.
Good, I know that.
Right. Name me four animals that come from Africa.
Three giraffes and an elephant.
No. What a stupid answer.
What a stupid question. All right.
We'll try you on places.
Good.
What do you know about Damascus?
It kills 99%. With all known guns.
Places. Where are your Andes?
On the end of your wristies.
No, yeah, thank you. Let's try on religious subjects.
I'm good at that.
Right, yeah. Who was born in a stable and followed by millions?
Red Rum.
No. What was Gandhi's first name?
Gucci Gucci. No.
What's a Hindu?
Lay eggs. Hindu. Hey, Hindu. Who do? Hindu. You do? What?
Come on. What do you know about Buddha?
Tastes a lot better than margarine.
Thank you. Come on. Who are you looking for?
The compere.
Compere?
Yeah. Who is he?
It's Max Bygraves.
Is he? I've heard he's just made a new record.
Is it an LP?
No, it just seems like it.
Right.
Governor.
You made a new record?
I have, Governor.
You have?
Yeah. Comes out on Friday. Does it? Yeah.
Would you like to sing a bit?
Okay.
He came into my life one Monday morning. I was only half awake. I was just about to rise. I heard a voice and suddenly stopped yawning. For peeping round the bedpost was a bear with big brown eyes. And I got fur around my fingers. I got fur around my toes. And it covers almost everything except my shiny nose. I haven't got a temper, but I have been known to square. And I hope you have enjoyed meeting me and Nookie Bear. Good night, God bless you.
When I shake hands with you, oh, blow me a kiss,
and that's lucky too.
and a brush well the flue. Well, I'm covered with soot from me head to me toes. A sweet nose is welcome wherever he goes.
Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim to me. A sweet prince as lucky can be.
Though I spend me time in the ashes and smoke, in this old wide world there's no happier bloke. Smoke is all billowed and curled between pavement and stars. Here's a chimney sweep's world where there's hardly no day and hardly no night. Those things often shadow and halfway in light.
On the rooftops of
sorry. Oh, I'm so out of breath. When a star is born, they possess a wish or two. One of them is this. They have the power to make a wish come true. When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Is in your dreams. No request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. Fate is kind. She brings to those who the sweet fulfillment of their secret longings somewhere over the rainbow, way up high. There's a in a lullaby somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops It's not where you start, it's where you finish. It's not how you go, it's how you land. A 2-1 shot with no ifs or buts. From the favorite, all it needs is the guts. Your final return will not diminish. And you can be the cream of the crop.
It's not where you start, it's where you finish.
That was really great. 13, isn't it lovely? Hey, I bet they're proud of you in Scotland, aren't they? Is your mum and dad looking in Scotland?
Yeah. No, they're here.
Oh, they're here?
Yes.
Where, in the theatre?
No, they're up the back.
Oh, where? Where are they sitting? Where are you?
Okay.
Oh, there, look, over there. Look.
Hello, Mum.
Hello, Dad. Hello. Is that your mum?
Yeah.
Mum, I thought it was Mae West who'd been up there. Lovely. And you want to say hello to Huey Green? He'll be proud of you tonight. Yeah. I've been standing in the wings looking at you, and I've just been trying to rack my brains who you remind me of. Who does she remind you of? Anybody? Who? No, you watch this, look. This will give you a clue, look. Have you guessed it? Show him a big smile, look. Jimmy Carter. Ladies and gentlemen, from Harlem, New York, the theatre, the dance theatre of Harlem. Here they are. Thank you. Isn't that great? What about that movement? You know, ladies and gentlemen, when I first came into show business, I didn't have much sense of rhythm. And it was a great handicap being a Catholic. And in those days, you had to have a hit record. And the first record I made wasn't a hit. It didn't make the charts. I'll be honest, didn't make the shops. But the second record I made went into all the Woolworths, into the Marks and Spencers, and that wasn't a hit either. Even the shoplifters were taking it back. And sometimes the records stood on the shelf so long, the hole in the middle healed up. And then one day I met Jeff Love, and Jeff Love had only just arrived in this country. He still had the oars in his hands. And all that he owned was what he stood up in, a loincloth and a string bag with his nuts at the back. And he said to me, he said, listen, he said, why don't you do a sing-along? He didn't say that exactly. He said, Mahoga, but you know, these royal performances have been going on since about 1912. And names on the bill were people like Vester Tilly and G.H. Eliot. And these people couldn't survive without an audience joining in. So these records that I make, I do them with... A lot of people ask me who the choir is. It's an act called the Tony Mansell Singers. And we're going to do a sing-along for the first time, I think, in any royal show. And if you don't sing, I'm going to do the deck of cards. Let me call you sweetheart. I'm in love with you. Let me hear you whisper that you love me too. Keep that love. Honest, I do. You're so sweet. If I could just hold your charms again in my arms, then life could be complete. Since you've been gone, dear, life don't seem the same. Please come back again. And after all said and done, there's only one girl of my dreams, it's you. Well, the blue of the night beats the gold of the day. Someone waits for all the ladies by themselves on the gold of her hair.
And the gold of her hair
crowns the blue of her
hair. Crowns the blue of her eyes.
Like a halo tender
like
bright.
A halo tender.
Beautiful. All the gentlemen, if only I could see her.
If only.
Where you from? Red the corpse?
Oh, how heavy a life.
All together now, where the blue of the night.
Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day. Someone waits for me.
Joan, my pleasure now to introduce to you a very fine comedian, new face to us, to a lot of us. Really, really good. I think you're going to enjoy this boy. His name's Tom O'Connor.
You know, it's frightening. Because it's not just us tonight, you know that, do you? The eyes of the world are watching. And why? Because we're a race apart, that's why. Do you realise that Britain is the only nation anywhere in the world that can't afford to be sick? You try it. Try it tomorrow. Go to the doctor, tell him you're sick. He's too busy. You've got to ring him up and say, I'm thinking about being sick in January. True. You can't run into his surgery with a knife in your back and shout shop. I mean, you're lying in a pool of blood and the nurse is saying, is it urgent? You should have rung before 10 o'clock, you know. Thank God we're conditioned to it, which we are, aren't we? Even the kids. Because the kids today would hang you, wouldn't they? Hey? I had this when I was teaching. I remember the phone went one day and the voice said, Jimmy Brown won't be in today because he's not too good. The headmaster said, who's speaking? He said, me dad. But you see, compared to this, teaching was easy. It's very difficult for me to be here because, you see, for a start, coming from Liverpool, I've been up all night learning to speak English. And how am I doing? And that's not my main problem, you see. My biggest problem, of course, probably the same with all the fellas in the room, will I be able to find a box in the morning to send the suit back in? Because... see, we don't normally come down from Liverpool dressed like this because we come every 2 years, win the cup, go back. And... you see, and of course, people think football's a religion. It's nothing to do with football, why we come away. It's mainly to get away from the wife. Because men, you know what it's like with wives. Nag, nag, nag. How come we can't have a new car like next door? I haven't been on the dole as long as him. See? And you see, what people forget is that the cup final isn't just a game. It's a ritual. So you get the coach up, and the women wave you off. Wave to your dad. May never see him again. With a bit of luck. And the lads sit by the windows of the coach saying, I'll give you a ring when I get there, love. And the coach pulls out and the cry goes up. Feeling a bit dry here, driver. And he says, well, let me get out of the street, lads. And you've set off early, Thursday afternoon. So you'll get there handy Saturday and by the time you arrive at Wembley, you've had a pint in every pub in the British Isles. You get caught in funny situations. Like the lads came out of this halfway house in Birmingham and there's 100 Hell's Angels got the coach boxed in. Half a mile up the road, the fellas on the coach were selling motorbikes and leather jackets. You get to the ground and then you suddenly think, good heavens, I haven't got a ticket. Oh, golly heck. Mind you, who needs tickets to get into Wembley? I mean, the experienced football fan just goes in through the front door. You've seen them. One bloke with a Woodbine packet.
Press.
Three fellas with mouth organs. Irish Guards Band. And the all-time classic. Flat hat and a Woodbine. Shah of Persia. Shah of Persia's mate. It's our style, but I find it, foreigners must find it awful difficult to sort of adapt to us. Because for a start, you see, nobody in Britain actually speaks English. Have you noticed that? True, we make our own words up. You've heard them. Where have you been? Had to go to the vets. The cat's been as sick as a dog. What chance has a foreigner got with them? And it's not just fellas, women are the same. Got a little lad hanging by his fingertips from a block of flats and his mother shouting up, listen here, Jimmy, you fall off there and break your legs, don't come running to me. So, And of course, you see, the only times we ever meet foreigners are either in Marks and Spencer's or behind the counter, or when we go abroad. And that must be frightening. I mean, when foreigners see us first landing in Spain, because you know the way it is, we've saved up all year, we're going to Spain. And you sign into the hotel. Hello, señor. Have you got a reservation? Who do you think I am, Geronimo? Is this your wife? Come on, pal, you don't think I'd live in sin with her, do you? You go to the bar to practice your Spanish? Hey, because we're good at Spanish, aren't we? You've heard him. You all. Bringo to me, oh. Two O. Coco Colo. And his wife says, oh God, Harry, aren't you good? And he says, I was here in the war, you know. When you're abroad, wives always want you on the beach. Have you noticed? Come on, with the kids. If you were half a man, you'd take them to the circus.
If I was half a man, I'd be in the circus, wouldn't I?
Out on the beach, you've got all your Tarzans of Europe. You've seen them? Big bronzy. They pump them up for the summer. And out comes Britain's answer. Rolled up trousers. Knotted anky. Vest and braces. It's 103 in the shade. And he's carrying an overcoat. He's paddling in 2 inches of water. Got the wife on a rock looking out for Jaws. The courier takes you out to the Benedictine monastery to watch the monks making the wine. And the little abbot says, we're going to sample the wine which the monks make, now the most that any man can drink and remain standing up is 3 glasses. Then the monks will come into the open air and sing the hymns. So they go in for a few jars. They come out, he's missing. And out come the monks. The last monk out is wearing a knotted anky. The world record, 3 glasses. This man has destroyed it by 2.5 bottles. Save your missus for me. There's a monk at the front swinging the incense. And he's shouting, hey, pal, your handbag's on fire. And seriously, you're a lovely audience. And I hate to be the one to break the news, but unfortunately, this evening there'll be no bingo. So in order to fill the gap, I thought I'd sing a song. So with the assistance of Gordon Rose and the others who couldn't get tickets... have we got a G7, Gordon, is it? Yes, any of those. Thank you. Up in the morning, out on the job. Work like the devil for my pay. While that lucky old son, he's got nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. Fella going up the street like that. His mate said, what are you doing? He said, shh, I've just pinched these boots and haven't had time to cut the string. Sweat for my kids, work till I'm wrinkled and grey. While that lucky old son, he's got nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. stranger at the bar. Fella come in, he said, you want to buy a watch? He said, what's it like? He said, shh. Bloke next to you is wearing it. All about, don't you see I'm pining? Tears all in my eyes. Send down that cloud with a silver lining and lift me to paradise. Conductor on the bus. Went to the front, two nuns. He said, right, girls, first, please. They said, we've left our purses in the convent. He said, give me your names. They said, we're two of the sisters of John the Baptist. He said, right. Went down, two stops after he was back. He said, you two, off. John the Baptist, dead. Show me that river, take me across, and wash all my troubles away. Like that lucky old son, give me nothing to do. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, the greatest gift you can give any child is time. And certainly the greatest gift you can give any comedian is time. Can I thank you for giving me a little bit of your time? Good night, God bless you. But roll round heaven all day.
Very proud of him in Liverpool tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Now, we've had a lot of romantic singers from France, Charles Aznavour and Sacha Distel. This man that's coming on next has written more hits than anybody I have ever known, ever. He has written things like What Now, My Love, Let It Be Me, Sea and Sand. Ladies and gentlemen, it's always lovely when these overseas artists come for a thing like this here, a do like this. They give up all their time, all their energy. So give a very big welcome to Gilbert Beco. Gilbert Beco.
I bless the day I found you. I want to stay around you, and so I beg you, let it be me. Don't take the seven from one, if you must stick to someone, one and forever, let it be me. Each time we meet, love, I'll find complete love. So never leave me lonely, tell me you love me only, and that you'll always let it be me. If for each bit of gladness someone must state of sadness, I'll bear the sorrow, let it be me. No, no matter what the price is, I'll make the sacrifices through each tomorrow, let it be me. To you I'm praying, hear what I'm saying, please let your heart beat for me, just me. And never leave me lonely, tell me you love me only, and that you always let it be me, let it be me.
Thank you.
own. And what you need, a little love and understanding. A little warmth to tell your soul. A little bird that softly sings. Each night my voice happened to sneak through your transistor radio. Oh, oh, oh. I'm just a secret you can keep, and no one ever needs to know. You're in that city far away, you're on that ship way out at sea. You've got the problem you can't face, so leave them behind any place. For out of sight is out of mind. And in time, 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 you'll find peace of mind. Okay.
Okay.
Your room is like a desert isle. You often feel with silent tears. Here. So grab your coat, put on a smile, and go outside, go buy some cheer. Why sit there thinking of the past, recounting empty days gone by? When you should make each moment last, it's not so hard to do. Just try. You're in that city far away. You're on that ship way out at sea. You got the problem you can't face, so leave them behind any place. For out of sight is out of mind. And in time, 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 you'll find peace of mind. Okay. Voilà, joue monsieur, joue bien monsieur. You can't face, so leave them behind any place. For out of sight is out of mind, and in time, and in time, and in time, and in time, and in time. You're doing here? Look, it's you or not.
Wait.
What are you doing here, Rosie? What are you doing on the balcony? Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry, but I just saw this beautiful lady here on the balcony. This one here. On the balcony, you know, we used... C'est drôle, c'est pas toi. Ouais. We had an act together, you know? A dancing act a long time ago. And one day, you know, you remember Rosie and Joan? Rosie and Joan? Voilà. Rosie and Joan. And one day, she just left, you know? No more Rosie and Joan. It's only today, Joan and Joan, right? So I hope you're not gonna be bothered if I speak French to her a little bit, because we used to. Ça va, mon bébé? Qu'est-ce que tu fais là? Ça va? Écoute, est-ce que c'est par hasard si tu promenois ce soir? Ou bien, est-ce que t'as vu mes affiches dans les rues? C'est plus Rosie and Joan, c'est seulement Joan and Joan. Et Joan, il va très bien, et Joan, il n'a besoin de rien, rien. D'ailleurs, tu n'as qu'à voir si t'as payé pour voir ce soir, hein? C'est pas plus mal qu'avant, hein? C'est même plus dans le vent. Tu te souviens de ce pas? Tu n'y arrivais pas? Écoute, écoute, faut partir du pied droit, tac, 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 comme ça, comme ça. Excusez-moi, messieurs, mesdames, c'est Rosie, c'était ma femme. Elle était là dans mon numéro. C'était quoi? Un duo. On dansait pst, comme personne. C'était nous, les Rosie and Joan. Mais la vie, c'est la vie. Et la vie, voilà. Depuis que t'es parti, la maison a grandi, tu sais. Pour nous deux, c'était petit, mais pour moi tout seul, ça suffit, tu sais. Hey, j'ai appris la cuisine, hey, le sandwich aux sardines, c'est bon. Et je change de chemise, quand je change de chemise, pardon. Histoire de rigoler, je suis pas prié, tu sais, tu me connais. Tiens, dimanche, avec Gaston, tu te souviens de Gaston? On a tapé le carton, c'est bon. J'ai gagné tous ses sous, alors évalue-toi. Toi, t'as une veine de coucou, il m'a fait. Il est rigolo, hein? Le salaud. Excusez-moi. Messieurs, mesdames. Rosie. Ma femme. Tous les deux, là. Dans mon numéro. Un duo. On s'aimait, s'aimait. Comme personne. C'était bon, hein? Rosie and Joan. Mais la vie, c'est la vie. Je sais. Et la vie, tu sais, ça va. Ça va. Ça va. Rosie! Thank you.
What now, my love? Now that you left me, how can I live through another day? Watching my dreams turning to ashes, and my hopes eaten to bits of clay. Once I could see, once I could feel, now I am numb, I've become unreal. I walk the night without a goal, stripped of my heart, my soul. What now, my love? Now that you left me, I feel the world closing in on me. Here come the stars trembling around me. Here the sky where the sea should be. What now, my love? Now you are gone. I'd be a fool to go on and on. No one would care. No one would cry if I should live. Goodbye. Goodbye.
gentlemen, Dawson Chance and Friend. This is Big Al the Kangaroo. Ladies and gentlemen, Big Al.
Oh, I say.
But tell me, Big Al, have you had time to look round London?
Oh, yes, sport. This afternoon, I hopped on a bus.
Where did you go?
Straight through the flaming roof.
Well, what did you do then?
Well, I went through a cup of tea. Cost me 60 flaming P.
60p?
Yeah. The waitress, she kept staring at me. She said, "We don't get many kangaroos in here." I said, "It's 60p a cup, I'm not surprised."
Then what did you do?
Well, actually, I went and had a look at Buckingham Palace.
Did you?
Yes. And you know what I did?
No.
I leapt right up high. Wahey!
What did you do up there?
I looked out at the garden wall.
What did you see?
Another kangaroo hopping up and down.
Really?
Yeah. He was only tiny. I said, "Oi, shorty. You're a little fella for a kangaroo."
He said, "I'm not a kangaroo. I'm a corgi and I've just sat on a stinging nettle."
I bet that made his eyes water.
Yes. Actually, have you come over here on your own?
No, I brought the lodger.
Where is he?
Down there. Oh, get in out. Is he? Come on out of it. Come on. Don't get... Oh, there you see.
So that's him, eh?
Yeah.
Can he speak?
Oh, yes. Here.
Oh, quickly. This is...
Here. Say the first words you learnt when you arrived here in England. Excuse me, where is the Social Security?
Oh,
Oh, that's exhausted him now. I think we'd better go and have a cup of tea. And you're tying. Ta-da, ta-da.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from Australia, Wayne King.
Thank you. One of the greatest American 20th century composers, who is famous for his wonderful concertos, operas, and rhapsodies. But I guess he'll be specially remembered for the many beautiful songs he wrote with his brother. And of course, I speak of the wonderful music of George Gershwin.
Thank you. sorry, mate.
Oh, really need that much, did we? Good evening. Oh, I love live television. Ladies and gentlemen, are you all happy? Yeah. Good. Yeah, you look very happy considering you could have sat at home and watched it for nothing. I'd like to start with a question, if I may. Are there any politicians in? I have to check for obvious reasons. Oh, really? Oh, on the right, so that doesn't bother me. No, No, last time I was honoured to be in this show, 72 actually, the politicians came in that night and they sort of sneaked in without telling me. Cyril Smith came in. Oh, yes. He sat on that row down there. But I've got to be very careful tonight because during the rehearsal today, Lord Delphon said to me, he said, Mark, it's a very good spot. Very good spot. Billy, give him a cigarette. No, very good spot. But be very careful, with the political gags. I mean, well, one wrong word from you and I could end up a commoner again. And then, of course, we've got Bill Cotton, the head of light entertainment for the BBC. He's been in a panic all day about political jokes. He said to me, he said, now, be careful what you do. Be careful what you do. Very BBC, repeats everything. See, because tonight I was going to start with an impression of Larry Grayson, and I thought, well, I could get to like it. But... mind you, you know what they used to say, if you did it well, it kept you out of the army. But, no, you see, Larry is a very funny comedian, no doubt about that. But if I was to do Larry, and I could get stuck like that for the entire performance, and I'd be confused later on. Well, let me explain. You see, I'd be half Larry Grace and half somebody else. They come in on doing Ted Heath and saying, what a gay day! Could you imagine? Could you imagine Harold saying, shut that door? But actually, I'm here tonight really as a replacement for all the artists who weren't available to appear. Now, that's quite true.
That's not true.
No, it's quite true actually because I know for a fact, I know for a fact Ken Dodd should have been on tonight, but unfortunately, a week last Sunday, he went on at the stage at the Opera House Blackpool and he hasn't come off yet. But I was told that there'd be somebody here tonight that would appreciate a few horse racing jokes. And, yes. Now, I know nothing about horse racing. And I'm not the only one. I once asked John Rickman for a tip and he said, never tie your shoelace in a revolving doorway. As far as I know, it's still running, but however. Now, I do love to watch the sport on television, and Saturday afternoon, I love Grandstand, and particularly the Rugby League. Now, I don't know whether you watch the Rugby League on television or not. Do you watch the Rugby League on television? Do you? A pity, this is Harry Worth. Just throw him in there, let him bounce around a little. No, it doesn't matter whether you understand the Rugby League or not, because everything is explained very clearly by the commentator, and I refer, of course, to little lovable, cuddly Neddy Waring. And I wonder what he'd say if he was here tonight. Well, thank you very much, Frank. It's very nice to be here at 1976 Royal Variety Performance. Bit of clapping there. Wow. We've had a very good show here tonight, and I've enjoyed all the acts on tonight, particularly that little lass, Lena Zavaroni, very good indeed, and the other lad, very good for Gilbert Beckett, Tom O'Connor. Anyway. But what really impacted me tonight, Frank, and I thought I'm very good, I'll have a second look at these, because I did enjoy the Harlem dancing. Now, they're very reminiscent of what we've got in Yorkshire, because, in fact, I thought they were very good, the Harlem dance, especially when they did the scrum there. That was very good. And... making me laugh, and I heard it at rehearsals. The Harlem dancers are very reminiscent of the Bradford Black Bottom dancers, and
The Halifax Okey Kirky Clog Dancing Formation Team. They're very good. That's all you're getting. Back to Frank Bach. Oh, sorry. Thank you very much. You know, someone said to me the other day, have you ever met Eddie Waring? I said, no, but I've met his solicitor. Mind you, it's a good thing if you do impersonations in your act, because if the act doesn't go well, you can blame it onto the people who've impersonated. And, well, I mean, apart from that, on occasions like this, if you're a little bit tense or nervous, you can hide behind somebody who's relaxed, you know, like Dave Allen, for instance, you know? You think? Billy Marsh gets everywhere. Sorry, a little Crowley joke there. Fella goes into a Chinese restaurant with a gun in and a stocking, a gun on. No, a stocking over his head and a gun in his hand. Not difficult, you know, to do really. He went into the Chinese restaurant and he went up to the head waiter and he stuck the gun in his back and he said, give me everything you have in the till. And the head waiter said, yes, sir, would you like it to take away? May your God go with you, anyway. But you know, there are some people you can, in fact, impersonate, and you can recognize them before they say a word.
Hey! Thank you. Thank you so much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen and children. Nice to see you,
Hi.
Oh, what a wave of indifference that was. All right, well, let's have a look at the old score. Are we feeling better, Bruce, if you watch it? Let's have a look at the old score. All right, after my love, yeah? Give us a twirl, yeah? Now the other one. All right, my love. But what we're going to do now, she does love waving her arms about. Let's clean that up. Now come over here, my love. Over here. What we're going to do now is a very simple game. Over here, my love, over here. What we want you to do is over here, my love, over here. Dear, oh dear, over here! And sit down there, my love, and keep thinking all the time. Keep thinking. Wine glasses, yeah. Plate of rhubarb, yeah, cuddly toy, yeah. Think of putting things in, yeah. The mind boggles. What else? Something else? Tape recorder. Don't help her. A food mixer, tape recorder. We've had tape recorder, you silly cow. Think of something else. Do they get them from? Go on, think of something else. A candelabra, yeah. A conveyor belt, yeah, Oh, get off your greedy thing. Give it a round of applause. Good game, not easy. All right. Hey. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play a very simple game, and it's a very lovely game, because all you've got to do now is watch something, and when you've seen what you've seen, we want you to do something else. And what we want you to do is watch a very... we want you to... I'll tell you to laugh. What we want you to do is watch a very funny comedian. If you think this comedian's funny, all you've got to do is laugh, and here is that very funny comedian.
Sunshine in your smile, filling rainbows all the while. In this world where we live, but there should be more happiness. So much joy, you come on, to each brand new fight tomorrow.
Evening all. Follow that with the sea lions. Choreography as well, by Lionel Blair, on a good day. Tonight I was going to bring with me my own personal musical director, Mr. Andre Previn, the thinking man, Sid Lawrence. What a shame. Unfortunately, Sid Lawrence, he couldn't be with us tonight, Andre Previn. He's doing a gig with Art Garfunkel. Can we say that? Garfunkel? Oh, we can, but we mustn't say Sid Lawrence. Incorrect, as we did before, yes. Has Max said Sophie Tucker? Carefully, all good. Now,
It is very tragic why we are earnless this evening. Little Ern was at home last night, leaning over the bath, washing his money. With his little loofah. Ooh. Not a pretty sight. When inadvertently, his wig fell off. Straight down the plug hole. However, he's having another one knitted. What he's doing about the wig, I do not know. 7, 8, 9. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine.
Thank you very much.
Isn't he lovely, Eric Morecambe? Really is. Lovely comedian. Actually, Eric's, of course, is very famous for that saying, what do you think of the show so far? And I thought this evening it might be interesting if we were to ask one or two very well-known politicians what they think of this show so far. And who better to put the questions than Mr. Robin Day?
Good evening.
But I'll soon put a stop to that.
In other words, no one enjoys themselves this evening. Not except me, that is. However, tonight we're going to put these questions to various politicians, ask them what they think of the show so far, and first, let's turn to the Chancellor of the Exchequer. Mr. Dennis Healy. Mr. Healy, what do you think of the show so far?
Well, first of all, Mr. Day, before I answer your question... Before I answer your question, let me say that, you know, I have a motto left over from my old army days. If it moves, tax it. But let me say, I think tonight's show has been most excellent, and, you know, due to the economic crisis, I have instructed Miss Shirley Bassey not to sing Big Spender. As you know, that tune is from that very famous stage musical, Sweet Charity, or as we call it, Sweet IMF. But let me also say that I have enjoyed the show, but I object to one thing, quite categorically, and I do object to them televising the event. The artists tonight are entertaining millions of people, and therefore making millions of people happy, and therefore undoing all the work I've done.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Healy. Now let's ask Mr. Edward Heath. Mr. Heath, what are your reactions to Mr. Healy's remarks?
Well, of course, once again, Mr. Healy is completely wrong. I appreciate the enthusiasm, but where were you when I needed you? But, of course, Mr. Healy is quite wrong. In this day and age of economic strife, created, I hasten to add, by this Labour government, we need entertainment, and above all, we need laughter. And we need someone to laugh at. This is why we in the Conservative Party have Mrs. Thatcher.
Well, follow that. Well, Mr. Heath, that was droll, if not particularly informative. However, let's now go from comedy to tragedy and meet David Frost.
Hello, good evening and welcome. And we've just heard that since Lou Grade and Bernard Delfont became life peers, the House of Lords is now known as the First House of Lords, Second House of Lords, and matinees on Saturday. dicing with death tonight. However, let's now continue with the third of my two interviews with Sir Harold Wilson. And eat your heart out the two Ronnies. Let's now ask Sir Harold Wilson one very important question. Tell me, Sir Harold, was it easy being the Prime Minister of England?
No. Sit down. No, please sit down. No, I mean... And that does include everyone, it really does. No, I think in answer to your question, the question you asked me 20 minutes ago, David, no, I think that it wasn't easy being Prime Minister. I think I possibly misled the British people by making it look easy. Tell me, Sir Harold, a lot of people implied, and some people even said, that you got out when the going was tough. No, I do not accept this. I did not get out when the going was tough. I simply made way for an older man. And talking of that older man, what advice, Sir Harold, would you give to Mr. Callaghan at this moment in time? I think my advice to Jim Callaghan would... And I told him this the other day in the House of Commons. I think my advice to Jim Callaghan would be, make sure your passport is up to date. Could it be then, Sir Harold, that you left office because you didn't particularly relish the thought of facing Mrs. Thatcher in a general election? Ah! Oh, my! Oh, Mary, come and listen to this. He's very funny. Let me say, David, there wasn't one member of the Tory party, the Liberal party, or any other party that I feared. There were one or two members of my own party who put the wind up me from time to time. Tell me, Sir Harold, and we're running a little short of time, tell me, what about your honours list?
Well, I'll do what I can, but I can't promise anything. Super, absolutely fantastic. One final question, Sir Harold. What do you consider to be your greatest political achievements during your premiership?
Well, of course, we haven't got all night, but... I think in this order, my greatest achievements were, firstly, getting out when I did. Never in my wildest dreams did I expect enthusiasm for an audience who could afford £50 for a seat for a show. However, I think my other great achievement, and I said this, I made this quite clear at the Brighton Conference. It's in the book. I think 1966, when we won the World Cup, and I think... I think once under the Tories, we didn't even qualify. And then... Then just 48 hours before vacating Downing Street for the last time, I gave this country the ultimate. We won the Eurovision Song Contest. Save all your kisses for me, save all your kisses for me. Bye-bye, baby, bye-bye. Catchy little thing, Mary likes it.
Well, Sir Harold, I'm sorry we've run completely out of time. That was fascinating. I had no idea you couldn't sing, and thank you for being with us. And now from the former Prime Minister to the present Prime Minister, though. It's doubtful if anyone would have him as a present, but... Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome the Right Honourable James Callaghan? Good evening to you. You know, when Jack Jones asked me to form a government... One of my first duties when I entered number 10 Downing Street was to open all the windows and let out the tobacco smoke. But let me say to you, it's not all gloom. It's much worse. And it isn't just myself facing this crisis. Dennis Healy, for instance, has the most difficult task in this government. Is there anyone here this evening who would have his job? Think it over and drop me a line, care of 10 Downing Street. Now, I'm not the sort of Prime Minister that will bore you with political catchphrases and slogans such as, you've never had it so good, this will not affect the pound in your pocket.
And I give you my word at a stroke.
I was born in Portsmouth. The only catchphrase we knew there was, hello, sailor. I had an elementary education. That was last week when I attended a cabinet meeting. I didn't go to Eton, I didn't go to Harrow, but then again, neither did the Queen. But let me say to you, quite bluntly, I intend to govern this country. And there are those who say I'm a dictator, but when I find out who these people are, I shall have them flogged. I intend to continue the very successful give-and-take relationship with the TUC. They have assured me as long as we're prepared to keep giving, they'll keep taking. Only last week, Mr. Len Murray came up to me and shook me warmly by the throat. He said, Jim, we must earn an honest week's wage for an honest day's work. But let me just say one final word about education. We is not worried about the illiteracy in this country. Although there are some who can't even pronounce my name correctly. You know, some people say Callaghan and some people say Callaghan. Well, it is spelt or pronounced a certain way, and let me explain. It's Calla with an H, not Calla with a G, cause Calla with a G goes G, not H. It's H instead of G, so let us all agree, it's Callaghan that's me, C, no G. Good night to you.
Your heart doesn't ever feel at home. You fight the world and tell
today goodbye. The sweetness and the sorrow. We did what we had to do. And I won't forget what I did for love. What I did for my eyes are dry. The dream was ours to borrow. It's as if we always knew. And I won't forget what I did for love. What I did for what we'll remember. today goodbye. And point to a tomorrow. Wish me luck the same to you. How we pair. sending the clowns. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? One who keeps tearing around, one who can't. Just when I stop, for burning love, find word in a wing one that I wanted was yours, making my entrance again with my usual. Losing my timing this late in my career, and where are the clowns? Quick, send in the clowns. Well, maybe next year. So I face the final curtain. My friends, I'll say it clear. I state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every highway, but more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. But more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I've been on more than I could chew. But give it all, when there was stuff, I ate it up and spit it up. I faced it all and I tore and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing. Now I see it subside. I find it all so amusing to think I need all that. And may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a woman? What has she got? If not herself, then she has not.
To have entertained you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, the Nylon Blair Dancers. The Nigel Lithgow Dancers. The Tony Mansell Singers. The Musical Directors of the Stars. The Dance Theatre of Harlem. Paraguay. Person Chance. Wayne King. Tom O'Connor. Roger DeCourcy. Lena Zavaroni. And Shirley Bassey. Thank you.